Chair is the CEO of the company. He's with me. He's indicative of the new genre of techpreneurs, I would like to say, in Kenya. Give us a sense of what business Seven Seas Technologies is in.
We are a big integration company in areas of telecommunications, banking, and government. So what we do, we go in and sort of help customers implement business systems to support them in decision making, from intelligent systems to infrastructure to training and into consulting.
So you started out in 1999, and when you started the company, today it's not just a Kenyan company. Where else are you and what do you do there?
We have grown our business. I think you just mentioned our last year we closed our numbers at $33 million. Our business has been growing. We definitely have been seeing ways to grow our business into other markets. Currently we are in Zambia, we are in Zimbabwe, we are in Ethiopia. We've got we're in Kenya. We are exploring going to Ghana. Already we are there, seeing customers in Nigeria, and we see those other markets as markets that we think are going to be growth markets for us.
But you're almost in a club that there's not too many people in there. We don't see African entrepreneurs in the technology space moving not just from the traditional markets into across the continent. What hampers this kind of growth?
I think many things. One is capital. Second is also strategy in terms of what are you taking to market? What are you taking? Are you taking a specific good? Where is your competitive advantage? And also I think the general fear, okay, or for instance, why should a Kenyan company try and will we be successful in Nigeria? I think it's first is fear in terms of as entrepreneurs, and second, capital. But I believe now Africa is opening up.
Right.
We are in a very, very good area in terms of growth. We also look at the infrastructures available, even in terms of commute infrastructures. So
yes.
Today, going to Ghana, going to Nigeria, going to Zambia, going to Zimbabwe, there's almost a daily flights. So I think that is possible. And also talent is also available.
You're talking about a listing. Any more details about this since the last time we heard about it?
We definitely would like to unlock for shareholder value in our business. We probably will defer listing a little bit because currently we're on a capital raise exercise, but as to grow our business in Africa, we
right.
feel there'll be better value for shareholders if we truly become Pan-African. So we are hoping, let's say 2-3 years from today, we are in those markets, and quite big markets, and solid in those markets where we intend to set up.
Kenya is planning a $7 billion Konza Technology City and is almost calling itself the Africa's Silicon Savannah. Some, of course, criticize this as more of a real estate project than a technology project. But what are your feelings on this and the country's tech credentials as a whole?
I think the project is ambitious and definitely bankable. It's just a finite balance between, one, getting the right investors, I guess. At the same time, also being able to set and package Kenya as a platform or a country where we have capability. I think... So it's an ambitious project, and I support the government. I think it's a good project if they're able to pull it off. But I think it's subject to, I believe, getting the right donors, or not donors, financiers for that kind of project, I guess.
How do we spur innovation in technology in Africa, in Kenya and into the rest of the continent? Because you travel quite a bit around.
I think innovation is also, as I always say, it's an interesting big word, but we need to see our problems as solutions. We need to find ways in which whatever solutions we create for our own problems, we then can find ways to replicate and resell this across other markets. Sometimes, in terms of innovation, we are too caught up in let's buy this global product, or let's buy this global solution, but we forget that sometimes we can probably try and innovate at a local level. And even if we have to team up with global companies, try and say that the intellectual property of that product or that technology is then left in the home market, which you can then re-export to the next market. So, innovation, from our point of view, there's definitely a lot of areas of innovation. Creating value and locking value for that innovation is where I think we are struggling with. A lot of companies are struggling with, because you have lots of innovators.
Right.
But how do you commercialize? I think most companies are struggling, or most tech entrepreneurs are struggling in that area of replicability, and also getting unlocking value in terms of selling across Africa, and also sometimes thinking small. Thinking Kenya and not thinking Pan-African. Developing a product which cannot resell in Africa, probably
right.
in your own market. So we need to think more out of the box in terms of, we need to see Africa as one big market.
We'll leave it there. Mike Masharia, many thanks for coming in and sharing your insights with us.